Okay, you two.
Check that out.
This is my new Adam Stone custom.
I don't know what to say about this thing other than the fact that it's absolutely amazing. Adam and I have been talking for a couple years about making me a base, and finally I got one. Not much needs to be said. This thing is fantastic. You can tell what it is. It's a copy of Les Claypool's quarter string that he's been playing for years. Look at that. This thing is beautiful. It took Adam 6 months to build it, which for a custom base is ridiculously fast. We had been talking about this base for about since 08, and working out all the fine details and everything, getting it all made. Really happy with it. So I'm gonna give you guys, if I can, let's lower this a bit. Some sound samples. I don't have a fancy rig to where I can plug directly in and you can hear the bass, unfortunately. At least not right now. At some point in time, I'll get recording software so you guys can actually hear the basses in their entirety, but for right now, this is what we got. And this is the bass flat. I'm running right into my amp direct in with no EQ, so it sounds really, really good. I run through a Korg AX300, which is the same pedal Les uses, for the effects, and then I run through a Korg AX3B for my basic tone. That's when I'm running EQ. Right now everything's completely flat, so I turn on the EQ a little bit, and everything comes alive. I'm gonna play a couple songs, and maybe you guys will be able to hear it even better. So bear with me. I can't promise the sound's gonna be amazing, but I don't know what you want me to say. If you guys have any suggestions on software I can install on my Apple to where I can plug right in and record straight off the base, let me know. I'd love to do it. I'm tired of trying to set up my amplifier and my speakers to where they sound good together. It's a pain in the ass. But as of right now, that's all I got. So I'm going to play, I'll play a couple songs and you guys let me know what you think. Uh-oh. I think I unplugged my amp. Hold on. Please. is fucking amazing. We'll play... We'll do Pudding Time. Fuck that. Let's do it. Let's see, It should be good. What do you think?
We'll be right back.
batteries die.
I don't know what to play.
Everything's way too, just sounds way too good on this thing.
Alright, we'll do... I don't like this version, I hate it, but we'll do it anyway.
I'll say y'all on the thing.
the fact that I'm sweaty, is buy one of Adam's basses. Buy one of his basses. I'm trying to hypnotize you. Buy a bass. I've never played a bass this comfortable in my entire life. This is a 32. You should know. If you're a Les Claypool fan, you know what Les plays. Aside from the fact that I didn't pay around 10 grand for this bass, I paid a fifth of that. Guaranteed. I mean, the sound is almost identical. With, exception to the fact that Les plays with like $20,000 worth of gear, the sound is pretty much the same. And I'm very, 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 very happy with it. I mean, you get the whammy bar going, man. That sounds the same. Come on. What do you want? His website, if I'm not mistaken, is adamstonebasses.com. You can Google him. He's out in Connecticut. For what your bang for your buck is ridiculous. He'll charge you $1,300 for one of the nicest six-string basses you will ever own, and the nicest looking and the nicest sounding. You can't go wrong. I'm not trying to sell, but I waited. My first custom bass came from Josh Helms, and that was this bass, my Rainbow. Most of you guys have seen this one. Josh built me this one, and the reason why he built me that is because I didn't want him to build me this. I did not.